Brighton Vibe TV. From now on, we'll be bringing you a unique inside perspective on Brighton's music scene and culture. I'm here in the Bee's Mouth with Don and the Kicks. Over the last few years, Don and the Kicks have quickly ingratiated themselves with the Brighton music scene, becoming one of our top acts. Hi guys.
Hello.
So you're halfway through a European tour with Morrissey. How's it going?
It's going really well at the moment. Well, we've actually just finished it, but we've got another run of dates happening in October and November as well with him.
Great. What's your favourite destination so far?
At the moment, definitely. Russia destination-wise, definitely, because it's so different to the UK.
Obviously, spending so much time together in a sort of tight tour environment can test interpersonal relationships.
Well, there was a few spats, but nothing.
Minor fallouts.
Nothing really.
Tell us about them.
The worst one was actually in Moscow, and was it all
St. Petersburg? I think.
St. Petersburg, and it was after a particularly big night out, and we'd only had about 3 hours sleep, and I woke up to the sound of Matt screaming at Chris. Chris throwing a phone at Matt's head, and then his head started bleeding, and then Matt smashed his razor on the floor or something, and then I was nearly crying as well, because I was just like...
But that sort of thing, like, after the afternoon's done, it's just, you know...
So what's it like being on tour with an artist that's so revered by so many people?
It's amazing to watch, to see the fans, definitely, because you hear the stories about them, and it's actually all true. Like, when you watch people trying to jump on stage, and they're there from 9 o'clock in the morning outside the venue, waiting. Like, they do like patrols around the venue to see where what door he's going to come in at. And
they set a camera up at one place. Where was that? That was in Luxembourg.
Set a camera up on a tripod at the to film the backstage entrance and stuff.
But just to get a glimpse.
How big a factor was Morrissey liking the band in you getting the tour?
It was the only factor.
I was going to say, because that's quite unusual. Usually you'd have a booking agent assigning people,
wouldn't you?
I suppose, if you're that big, you do what you like. Hannah, obviously touring with three handsome young men, you know, have you ever been tempted?
Definitely not.
You've been quoted as saying you enjoyed the Absinthe on tour. Did you bring any back?
No, we should have bought a bottle really, because in Russia it's obviously a lot stronger than it is here. It was like 80%. Because you can only get it up to about 35% here, or 40% or something.
41%, and it doesn't have wormwood in it.
No.
Do you find it easier to write songs based on personal experience, or from a completely sort of fictitious standpoint?
Yeah, I mean, the songs... There's always at least an element of personal experience in every song, even the ones that are in the third person, rather than the first person. But yeah, I do tend to find that when writing lyrics, they're always better if you're talking about something that's actually happened.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you think it's important to show your influences when you play?
I don't think that we purposefully try and show any particular influences, but I think that we've all got very varied taste in music, and we just try and take sort of the best of songs that we like.
It's quite democratic.
Sometimes a bit too democratic, which is why we have we've ended up with a lot of different styles over the sort of three and a half years we've been a band.
Traditionally, the British music scene especially has been dominated by male singers. Recently, the tide seems to be changing a bit, with acts like Bat for Lashes, Florence and the Machine, LaRue. Do you think that you guys could be a part of that?
It's funny actually, because I was having a conversation with somebody after our gig, one of the Brixton gigs, and he was a quite important industry person, and his point was that he didn't think that we would be. Being female is not a genre.
Out of your contemporaries in the local Brighton music scene, is there anyone you'd like to see get more exposure?
I like Blue Skies a lot. I think they've got some good sounds.
Yeah, I think they've got some really good poppy tunes. Really like them from the beginning.
Third Man are good as well. And that's Max Rafferty from the Kooks, of course.
Yes,
that's right.
What are your favourite parts of Brighton and why?
The beach, when it's sunny.
The Bee's Mouth?
The Bee's Mouth.
I know that's your favourite part.
I love the Bee's Mouth. Yeah. There's a lot of talk in the music industry recently of bands choosing a DIY route, rather than being plucked from obscurity the way that people traditionally think of the music industry. So obviously you've achieved an awful lot without having a record label on board.
We've been kind of forced into the DIY approach because we haven't had any other option.
You can't wait around forever for someone to come and find you. It's like,
What's it like playing to a home crowd compared to playing abroad. Is there a big difference there?
Well, we did a leaving party at the Concorde just before we went on tour.
Yeah.
And that was amazing because, you know, it was full as well.
It's the reaction kind of varies from country to country.
Yeah, Germany was great.
Yeah, Germany's really cool. A lot of Eastern Europe was really cool.
So merchandise has been quite a big part of you, obviously, on tour as a band without a fantastic budget behind you.
I think you need to sell merchandise.
Yeah.
If we weren't, then we wouldn't have made it through.
Really? Well, what's your plan for the next few months?
Write and tour.
Yes.
Yeah.
Full-time work for August, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got to live for the next month. But then we've got our own tour in September and October, beginning of October. And then we're back with Morrissey end of October and November. So
great.
That's for next Brighton show, I think it's the 8th of October.
Yeah, 8th of October, that's
great. Well, guys, it's been lovely having you in. Thanks very much. I wish you the best of luck with the rest of your career and with the album. It's brilliant, so I'm sure it'll do very well. This has been Dominic Von Trapp with Don and the Kicks at Brighton Vibe TV. If you keep an eye on your PC or Mac, you'll be hearing more from us with new features that you won't find anywhere else over the next few weeks. Thanks again to Don and the Kicks, and you can buy their album off their MySpace, which is available now. You turn up, 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 you turn up.